everybody, and welcome back to Bacon with Tiff and Connor. Today we're going to make a granny cake and mommy Connor cake.
He's right, everybody. Today we're going to be making a granny cake, but Carter and I are going to share a little recipe with you that we like too, because we are not big pineapple fans, and granny cake has pineapple in it. So to start out with on your granny cake, you're going to use one yellow cake mix. You're just going to dump this right in the bowl here. Carter is mixing up our mommy Carter cake right now. Carter's dad really likes granny cake, but it has pineapple in it and optional, like, chopped nuts. Carter and I are not a fan of that. So we make a separate cake, and we use the glaze for the granny cake on it, and we call it a mommy Carter cake is what we've named it. So anyways, back to the granny cake. So we have our one cake mix, and then you are going to use one can of crushed pineapple. You're going to use all of the juices in that, and you're just going to dump that right in your cake mix. Once you get that all mixed together, then you are ready to pour that in your pan. But let's get that all mixed up for now. Okay, so as you can see, we've got everything all mixed up together here. This was just the juices from that pineapple and that cake mix. That's all you're going to put in this, and then you're going to put this in your cake pan. Make sure that you get all the cake mix out of there, all that dry cake mix powder. You see, we still got a few clumps around. Carter's doing a good job mixing up our mommy Carter cake. Again, that is just, you're going to make that cake mix right the way that it says to do it on the box, and then the difference is going to come up when you start to add that glaze. These are kind of like poke hole cakes. So what we'll do is we'll get this all spread out in here. We will bake this cake for about 35 to 40 minutes on 350. But before we do that, we are going to top this with some light brown sugar. I use about a half a cup per cake. You can also mix some chopped nuts into this, like I had said, to top this with. So we're just gonna coat that really good with this light brown sugar. Gives it a good topping.
Yep, it's kind of like good toppings.
Yeah, it's a really good topping, isn't it, buddy?
Yep. So, we actually mix it with goo, so it's kind of like almost like ice cream.
Alright, so we've got that topped. We're not going to be doing any chopped nuts today. We're just going to be doing that brown sugar. So again, we're going to bake this on 350 for about 35 to 40 minutes, or until it's all golden and done. You know, you put a knife or a toothpick in the middle and nothing comes out. Once we're done with that, we'll poke some holes in this cake, and then we're going to make a glaze. Now the glaze is going to consist of 1 cup of evaporated milk, 1 stick of unsalted stick butter, and then you're going to either use a half a cup of granulated sugar or another half a cup of brown sugar. That's totally up to you. Both ways, it's delicious. And you're just going to whisk that together and cook it down. Bring it to a good boil. As soon as it boils, you're going to take that off and you're going to just pour that over this cake. And it's going to be a nice glaze. It's going to make the cake really, really moist. So that's how you do the granny cake. So for the mommy Carter cake, you'll just go ahead and you'll bake that yellow cake mix. You'll do the same thing. You'll top it with a little bit of brown sugar, and then you'll make that same glaze for that. Let us know what you guys think, and
thanks for watching. Happy baking with my mommy Carter cake and granny cake.